Hello, folks, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer. As always, of course, I am Falcon, your host. I haven't really done anything since recording the last episode. I did recruit a witch hunter, because I just realized that we had one available. I had to recruit him all the way down here, because this is the only place that has a Temple of Sigmar available to us at the moment. So I went ahead and did that. Show me the accused. So he is going to travel all the way up here. I'm not entirely sure where I'm going to send him yet, but these guys are good. Well, number one, they're good for removing corruption. And they are basically the one that is good for eliminating enemy agents. The priests and the sorcerers and whatever. All these little guys that are causing problems all over the place. This is the main people who are good at that. No, you can use the others. They can accomplish things sometimes. But these are the ones who are the best at it. At least, they're the quickest at being good at it. Because he has, like, the assassinate skill almost immediately. Whereas the other ones, if you want to do something like that, let's look at the priest, for example. That's not going to tell me anything. Because that thing don't fucking work. He does, I believe, get something that'll do this. But you have to get far in before, yeah, see, his last thing on his list here will give him a bonus to the assassinate thing. But it's only a single point. You can only put one point in it. And it's the very last thing that you can do. So, you can't put points into basically anything else. If you want to be able to get that. Some of the other ones, the fighter guy. I guess all the rest of them you are over here. These, the captains might get a equivalent skill sooner. Yeah, see there. His middle one. But again, a single point. And it's still quite a ways in. So, better than the priest, but still not. That's not saying much. I don't even know if the mage may not. I imagine the mage has. Yeah, see, again. Again, it's a single point skill that you don't get until you're a ways in. Again, not as bad, but still bad enough. So, yeah, these are the people who are meant to remove enemy characters. And that's what he's going to be used for. He has to level up some, of course, before he can actually be useful, but that's what we're going to be doing with him. So we got this army. And maybe it was just that army from Wiesenland when they joined us. I thought I had another army from them, but I guess not. I guess that's the only one. Because this is the army I already had. Even though I really don't remember having great cannons. But I know I had you take Kemperbad, so that has to be my guy. I don't know. Whatever. So we have an army down here in Magdeburg. They're there to basically hold and secure that region. We have, of course, this army over here to hold and secure this region. Ready. You're kind of intended to hold and secure, like, the whole middle section here. You need some troops, which I will try to get you at some point, but I don't really have the money to do it right now, because I have to spend money on other far more important things before we can accomplish anything there. Of course, we got the army there, which is basically going to be defending this region. And then we have the one that's over here, which is actually one of my attack armies, because you're the primarily cavalry force combined with the Emperor's army. You're primarily meant to be attack forces. So I don't really have a defense for, like, this region over here, at least not right now. I am attempting to claim these, at least as many of them as we're going to be able to get to anyway, the territories here that we have already that have been destroyed by chaos. I'm going to try to claim all of, or at least most of them. That is going to take a while, unfortunately, but we're going to work on it. So, yeah, there's not really a whole lot I can do right now. I'm going to have to probably wait a couple turns for the Emperor's army to get back to full strength, and for your army to get back to full strength, before we can do this quest. And we just started trying to slowly build up our territory, really. So nothing really terribly going on. This episode, by the way, is the first episode, and in fact, the following Warhammer episodes are going to be the only series this month, at least. Everything next month will be this way. But these are the only... Everything else has already been recorded for this month, though. It's only the last few Warhammer episodes here that have not been. This is the first episode that I'm recording where I'm using my new monitor. I am not using a new video card, however. I do not have a 1080 yet. A GTX 1080, because they're still next to impossible to find. I've been trying to find one the entire month. I have one pre-ordered, but God only knows when that'll actually go through. So I'm trying to get one of the EVGA FTW for the win versions. Or a Asus Strix overclocked version. Those are the only two that I'm really terribly interested in. They're basically the two best ones. And EVGA really hasn't even started making them yet, their version. Asus has made Strixes, but they're extremely few and hard to find. To the point that it's basically impossible to find either one of them. This is going to improve as time goes on, but it's still going to take a while. And from what I've heard, we're going to have to wait really until July before you'll be able to find any of them. Which is pretty shitty, actually, but it's just the way that things are going to be, really, because that's all there is really to it. Alright, so you're going to take one, maybe two more turns to get yourself back to full strength. And, of course, it'll be the same with you, basically, so I will be able to spend my money on upgrades for a while. Those two cities are building up their first level of that. I would love to upgrade these kind of things, but I do need... Oh, so you don't have... Okay, well, I gotta fix that. You don't have a tap room in this region. You definitely need to have a tap room in this region. So I'm going to build one of those, which unfortunately is probably going to mean I'm not going to have the money to build one anywhere else, but we really need one here. Somewhere. Every region really needs to have a tap room, so that's something that we're just going to have to wait on, I guess. I think this region also probably needs one. Yeah, it does. Unfortunately, you don't have any growth available to do anything with that. We could upgrade you, but there's really no reason. You do have a tap room, okay. I was about to say you don't have one either, but you do, actually. You also have a shrine. Every region needs to have a shrine, every region needs to have a tap room. So that is a potential issue. We need to get a shrine built in this region at some point. I think that'll be the next thing that we build. And yeah, we should be pretty good after that. Once we have that built, we shouldn't be too bad off, I don't think. There's really nothing else here that I want to build, to be honest with you. I want to build a Reichsfort, so I guess we can build that. build that and build the temple here, and then I will build something else over here. Yeah, I guess that's how we'll almost have to run this, really. But we need 4,000 for both of those things. So I think we just skip the turn here, because we really have nothing done that I can actually do anything with, really. So I think we just progress. We're going to have quite a few turns here that I'm not going to really be able to do anything meaningful or useful, for the most part. Because there just isn't anything meaningful or useful that I can do at the moment. We're pretty much stuck with what we got. Anyway, yeah. So I am using my new monitor. It is a... I forgot what the resolution is. It's not 1080. It is the next main resolution up. I didn't go with a 4K one, because the 4K ones don't have the other features that I wanted. Okay, that's a potential problem, but we have another person basically to replace it, so it's fine. Basically, no meaningful effect to be had from that. Reichland is suffering corruption, but once we built this, that should solve itself. That, of course, is basically all of our money, but oh well. That's fine. You're still losing public order, but that should solve most of that. And then I think we're going to build here, we'll build it, the temple here, so I can do a level 3 temple for this region. Because I don't really need the ability to do anything else. Yeah, so one more turn should get you into full strength, and then we can at least do something with that army. We can make you at least mildly useful. Where are you going? Just like wandering in circles. Oh, do you not even have a leader anymore? I don't think you do. I think your leader must have been killed or something. Interesting. Alright, so we completed a technology. Which one was that? That's the charge bonus for mounted guys. Cool. So do we go with... Well, that would be useful. Extra growth. What does this require? A menagerie. Okay, so that's the demigryph thing. Right. And then this is the engineer workshop. I thought one of these would be require the mage thing, but apparently not. Oh well. Alright, yeah, I think we need to go with this. Cause we need to get rid of the corruption, and we need better public order. But the corruption's also hurting the public order, so we need to... I think I want to get rid of corruption first. Because public order is at least slightly easier to contend with. Although, maybe we'll do public order first. That's easier to deal with, but... more... immediately dangerous. Not necessarily more dangerous in the long term, but in the short term, more immediately dangerous. So anyway, continuing to explain my new... what the fuck is that? Must be like a ghost or something, the way it was moving. I'm gonna have to zoom in and look at it, because that looked really weird. Anyway, explaining my new setup. So I have the new monitor that I'm running at the whatever the hell resolution it is. I don't want to click over there, because that'll pop me out. and I still have my old monitor plugged in. And I'm going to continue to use my old monitor even once I get the new video card as a second monitor. And I'm able to put my recording software and all that stuff on the second monitor now, so I can actually see... Okay. This is probably going to go horribly for you. Do have a leader. A very high-ranked leader. Where the hell do you keep getting these high-ranked people from? Like, for real. I don't understand, but... I'm tempted to just auto-resolve this, because I'm pretty sure we will win it? But the problem is, if we don't... Damn, I don't know. I really kind of would like to just auto-calc this. I don't really want to fight this battle. But... fuck it, I'm just gonna auto-calc it. Yeah, okay. I figured we probably would win it. Yeah, see, we had way more troops than they do. I honestly don't even know why they bothered, to be honest with you. That was just kind of silly. They also probably just committed suicide, because I think the ally force that has been pursuing them is now going to be able to catch them. Or at least, so I would kind of assume. So you left. It's not necessarily that big a deal. Mission failed, but I could care less because it wasn't an important mission in the first place. Anyway, so having the new monitor, again, lets me set up the, I want one of these, but I don't know which one I want. What is this area's main problem? I guess corruption? Because we have public order coming back pretty strong here, so... I guess corruption, so go with that. And then... equip... the dude who gives you more money in regions. And I think... that's all we really need here. Okay, so yeah, these guys have been chasing them forever, so they're probably going to just catch them and exterminate them now without any real difficulty. But anyway, this new setup lets me obviously have all my recording software and everything on the one screen, which is really going to help me out when it comes to recording, because I can actually see the stuff now, and I can tell what I'm doing with it, and it gives me an opportunity to try to decide what I want to do here. It gives me an opportunity to be able to actually like look at and monitor my recording stuff, which before I couldn't do because, you know, I was just able to look at the screen. I would have to alt-tab out, which usually, you know, had at best a negative impact and at worst a severe impact on the recording of stuff. So you have that now. You still need a shrine. But in order to build a shrine, we need to upgrade something. Let's go ahead and upgrade, do a round of upgrading all the, like, the clothiers and these other things. Give ourselves more money coming in, because that'll be useful in the long term. I don't know who you are, but apparently you gained a level for no good damn reason, so I guess I'll take it. missile resistance would be good. Let's go ahead and take Marshall, though, because it'll help out with other things. Just in the grand scheme of things, it'll help. Let's see. Alright, take one of those. You should be fully restored now, so we can actually engage in that battle. Which I will do. Just gotta wait a second here to do it. I also have a additional program that lets me track my upload and download speeds, and my CPU and RAM usage, and like the time and additional things of that nature that I can put on the other screen, so I can kind of see, you know, how well my computer is and is not running things. And then the monitor also has an FPS tracker that you can't see it, because it's only on the monitor itself, but it's right here where the cursor is over the map on my screen. Is a built-in FPS tracker in the monitor itself, so if I so choose to have it on, and I think it's a pretty useful app feature, so I'm going to use it. But this whole setup, though, should help me to mitigate how long my episodes have been, because I'll actually be able to see directly how long the recording has been going on. Oh, this is gonna go terribly for you guys. We have you hugely outgunned. I mean, look at this. Oh, man. And we're defending, too? Whew. It's gonna go terribly for you. We're definitely gonna do it, though, because... our reserve is a little bit weakened, but it's fine. He's fine. Shouldn't be a problem. Let's go ahead and get in here and fight this. We've been needing to fight this for quite some time. They do have us hugely outnumbered numbers-wise, but we have, you know, all of our artillery that's just going to hammer them as they try to get near us. I do wish that I had some cavalry, though. My lack of cavalry is actually going to really hurt me here. I really wish that the Total War people, Creative Assembly, would increase the number of units that you can have in an army, because they have had... You've been limited to 20 people in an army, I think, since the very beginning. I think every single Total War game that has been the limit is 20 units of... 20 groups of units. Or, how the hell you say it? 20 units of troops. There we go. Which, honestly, I feel like isn't really enough. Especially as the stuff has progressed.
Hear me now, brave men, brave Reichlanders, hear me! The celestial wizards read the portents true. Norse raiders land on Nordland shores. We have marched many miles, but there is no distance so great that I would not gladly march it to face this, our ultimate foe. I have refused the honor of wielding the blade of our forebears thus far. I was not worthy, but should we survive this day, should we drive the ruinous tribes back across the sea, then, with your blessing, I will pick up the Reichland Runefang and use it to bleed our foes, to carve my way through Sigmar's enemies. Are you with me, men of the Empire? For when the Northmen come, they will attack hard, as their despicable gods demand. We must be ready to push them back, thrust them into the sea, in defense of the Empire!
Yeah, let's do it. This is actually not a bad arrangement, just how it did me here initially. It's not too terrible. Could be better, but I don't know that it could be that much better. For example, we could move back and position ourselves up here on the ridge, which is probably what I'm going to do. This is an interesting battlefield. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. Alright, so these guys, spread them across the terrain there. Put you guys here. Put you guys over here. Put the crossbowmen, because the crossbows do not need direct line of sight. They can arc their shots. Actually, no, they do need direct line of sight. These are not, they're not archers, they're crossbowmen, so they fire basically like a gun does. So yeah, they do need direct line of sight, so we'll put them in front. Of course, the artillery does not need direct line of sight, so that can go back here. It actually doesn't really matter where you go, you just need to be positioned. It's positioned where the tree won't interfere with your ability to shoot. There you go, get all four of them in front there. Okay, maybe don't put you behind the rocks, maybe put you in front of the rocks. Ooh. That's not a good position. Alright, eh, fuck it. Alright, there we go. Let's go ahead and start the battle. Stream forth from the beaches, push them back to the sea. That should be easy enough. What is this? Oh yeah, enemy reinforcements. Right. Coming in. That is a nifty, I guess that was a lighthouse. But it's fallen, obviously, into great disrepair over time. Another skull structure, or land entity, or whatever. Ooh, 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 stop that. This game has a tendency to, lock you into trying to turn itself, or trying to, move the screen for no real good reason. It's not the first time that it's done it. Probably won't be the last. Alright, I want you two to go after these two, these cavalry. Because I do not want them to be able to flank us. So go rock these guys' worlds. Slow the game down a little bit. This is the one that I want. Actually, no, let's not cast that. Let's not cast that there. Let's use... Let's use the comet. I want you to wreck those guys for me. I don't want them to be able to really give us any significant difficulty. Eat. Giant rock! Kaboom! Yeah, so they're dead. Pursue and destroy! The Empire endures! Moving faster! Alright, pull back. Fall back. You completed your objective, you were there to harass their horsemen. You definitely succeeded in that, so get yourself back. Oh, you guys need to not be there. Slow the game down. We need to move these guys out in front. Are those cavalry? No. Also not cavalry, okay. Right, so I have not seen this one before. This is new. Oh, so it is tracking. Good. I was hoping it would track them like it is. It's doing precisely how I wanted it, how I was hoping it would do. Hey, yeah, I'm aware that I've reached basically the end of our time, but that's fine. Artillery is continuing to fire, of course. That really did not have as significant of an effect as I had hoped. But I guess there's not a whole hell of a lot we could do about that. So, whatever. The Empire endures. Why are these guys getting past you? Oh, they're broken. Okay. That explains it. I don't know if you guys could hear that, but there was just a hell of a thunder outside for, like, real life. That was really loud. Like, I was... And, like, extended, too. It's not even that it was loud. It's like it went off and just kept going. It's kind of freaky. Alright, we are starting to get a little bit overwhelmed. Alright, trigger your bonus. Trigger bonus. Potion of healing. Does that affect everyone around you? I don't know. Don't actually know precisely how that works. I do know that we need something to break up this flank here, though, because we are getting hammered pretty good over there. They are retreating there in the front, which is good. We need them to retreat in the front. Alright, fall back, dude. Fall back. Alright, so we have another force that is coming in. We need to position ourselves to be able to contend with them. Get in there and try to crush these guys. Make them break so that they just leave. If at all possible, you need to break these guys so they just go away. Oh, shit. Alright. Fuck you too, buddy. Why are you out there? Oh, man. Well, you only get one of those? I guess you only get one of those. I guess that's a one-time thing. Or at least one time per battle, anyway. Hopefully it recharges, like, when a battle's over, but... It was definitely, obviously, a one-time per battle thing. Yeah, we are getting... We're getting pretty tore up here, but... We are winning, I think, but it is not... Not going easily. Okay, they're pretty broke. So. They're pretty much broken. So we need... What the fuck was all that? That was a piece of crap fucking hitting us with spells. Who the hell is he that he's still hitting us with spells? I don't even know where this shit is that he's hitting me with stuff. Wherever he is though, he's definitely nailing me pretty good. And repeatedly. Oh, there he is. Think. Is that him? Oh no, there he is. Get his ass. Just run him over. That's funny. Pretty sure that'll disrupt his casting of a spell, although I don't really know how that works in this game, but... I mean, they flood in. They're already dead. There's nothing to flood in. They're dead. Very dead. This guy's gonna die. I'll keep after the wizard. Keep after the wizard. Alright, kill that dude. I want him dead. Advance, gentlemen! Pick your targets! Hellstorm! Alright. Actually, no. Hit those horsemen. Fire on those horsemen. Take them out. And use your ability there. We catch that cavalry guy. Come on, kill his ass. Don't let him get away. You bloody idiots. Alright, except for getting experience, I don't think there's anything else that we can do in this battle because this is not a normal battle. This is a canned, predetermined fight. So I don't think anything else that we do is actually going to have any effect on anything. I don't think, anyway. I mean, I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure nothing we do at this point is going to really affect anything significantly, at least. Alright, so crossbows, range stuff is useful in this game. I like the artillery. The artillery is pretty cool. Oh, watch out. I'm actually kind of surprised to see the artillery firing at these guys. So how many of them died? Not as many as I would have expected, to be honest. That dude survived a charge from you. It got back up. Impressive, I suppose. Look how the Pegasus, like, jump around. So not only do they get up and, like, slam down, but they also do that jumping around. Attack, which is pretty cool. And the dive is pretty neat. No, I really don't think you will. Alright, we're gonna end the battle. There's no point in continuing. Oh, just completed a whole bunch of achievements. You can't see them, but a bunch of achievements just went off. And now I can actually look and see what you guys can see on the screen, so I can tell if things like the achievements going off and stuff is actually visible to the recording, which I could never really tell before. Well, without going back and, like, spending an inordinate amount of time watching the video and looking at the video footage and stuff, trying to determine if it was visible or not. And half the time not even be able to do that. Alright, so, yeah, we pretty well wrecked them. Basically destroyed them. And they got off the best of the group, of the bunch, but they still got tore up pretty damn good, so. So captured quite a few people. It gave us a bunch of money, but... It's not that much money. It's only 500. That's not really that big a deal. Oh! Those armies are alive? Or no? No, they disappeared. Okay. Alright, so we got the Reichland Runefang. Which is a powerful weapon with an additional ability. And a whole bunch of extra experience for him. Which is pretty cool. So he gained the weapon, which he equipped immediately. I'm assuming it's probably better than anything else that we have available to him. So I would assume. Let's take a look at it. Yeah, so before we had this, which is just a plus 6% to weapon strength, to attack. No, to damage, I guess. So we do more damage with that, but this gives us better attack, the public order bonus, extra loot, as well as that ability, which is going to, at least when you trigger that ability, that's going to give you a lot more damage for a few seconds at least than that did. Alright, that's pretty good. I'll take it. Okay, yeah, so the Potion of Healing is usable only one time of battle, but it does restore itself. It's kind of what I figured, but I wasn't completely sure. So that will begin at rank 18, so we're almost there. And I guess that's armor. Yeah, it's armor. Pretty good armor, too. Alright, so we can get his special mount. So we're definitely going to take that. There's no reason for us to take anything else. Because his special mount is unquestionably going to be the mount that we want. He'll be the mightiest Imperial Griffin that ever lived. Sweet. Yeah, so that gives us a hefty little weapon that we can play with. Displease me. Where the fuck did you come from? Yo, one of you is gonna kill him, so I'm not too worried. Not overly worried. Where the hell did the Hawkland army come from? What are you doing out of your place? Whatever. I need somebody to start chasing this guy. Nordland. Pretty sure the dwarf guys are gonna get to move before they do, so... I'm pretty sure Nordland gets to move before they do, for that matter. I think. Because I'm pretty sure they are one of the last enemies that goes. In fact, I'm pretty sure they basically are the last enemy that goes. So I want you to go chase these guys down. I'm actually not entirely sure that I want to even bother. Trying to go after them myself. Actually, maybe I should do this the other way around. Maybe I should let the dwarves go after these guys. Because you guys are not a full army. Yeah, I think I'm better off doing it that way. So Nordland, I changed my mind. You're going to go after that. And you guys are going to go after them. And Hawkland, I want you... to go after that. Doesn't really matter where specifically you go, because... we can't take these territories anyway, so all we can do is attack and damage them. So it's actually perfectly fine if... you, don't manage anything, like, really particular. Alright, so I'm going to send both of you... Karaknorn and Nordland will continue to try to defend my territory, although once this guy's fall, I'm going to have Nordland go on the offensive as well. This army, unfortunately, is probably going to give me some problems. Unless I can manage to get it. To catch it before they are able to,
To the provinces.
So you're not very strong, but if I put you in here and you have the reinforcements of the Gorsal garrison, you might be able to do what we need. Maybe. I guess we'll see. Man, I would really like to be able to get some sort of cavalry force, but all you could got is pistoliers, which are not that good. Well, they're not terrible, but they're not that great either. Alright, just do... no, that takes two turns. Fuck. Do some crossbowmen then, because we need some sort of ranged capability with you, now, and you need just more troops in general. So, I think we need to reinforce all of these armies to some degree. They don't necessarily need to have like huge amounts of reinforcements, but they definitely need something. How much money did I just spend on those reinforcements? Because... holy shit. Alright, you know what? I changed my mind. I don't want to do that. Because that is way too much money. I don't want to spend that kind of money on that if I can help it. Even though I probably just should do it, but... okay. There we go. I'd rather spend it on upgrading our economy. Alright, do I chase this army? I don't know that I do. I don't think I do. I think I go on the offensive instead. Really, I think that's smarter. No, you dumb piece of crap.
As is my right by Sigmar's crown. Fine. Right? In the name of Magnus.
Where are you trying to go?
Yes, to unite the provinces. Not while I reign. I am Franz. They will obey. On it.
Whatever. You're bloody stupid, so it's fine.
What does the Emperor bid?
Alright, so we need to upgrade this with something. And the other one over here, for that matter, was something too. Oh man, you are losing. You're losing pop really serious. You're losing happiness at a prodigious rate without anybody there to be in charge of the place. I have no money to do anything, so we need to just end the turn, I guess. And I need to actually end the episode, so this is gonna be it. Thank you for watching, folks. Like and subscribe if you enjoy my stuff. I will see you in the next one. Yeah, that is definitely like a ghost or something. Like, doing weird shit. Ooh. Crap. Okay. That's not good. Oh, you actually gonna attack them? Huh. Alright. Cool. Where are you going?
Greetings. All you survey are loyal to me, so I advise caution with your next words.
What do you want? A non-aggression pact? Sure. I'll happily try to ally with a couple more dwarven factions. Because I might be able to make good use of a couple more dwarven allies, just like we're making use of these guys. You were going the wrong fucking way there, buddy. I wanted you going to go help me with this guy. You are not going that direction, though. You're going the other way. Why are you going the other way? Whatever. Oh, of course they're raiding. Of course they are. Of course they are.
Sigmar compels us.
Alright, so go right into there. That will help with a bunch of things. You should also be able to defend the area. Although I don't know that you could defend it against all of this. Without reinforcement, at least. But what can you really do? I mean, not a whole lot, so whatevs. Oh man, doing the global recruitment is fucking expensive, man. Jeez. Good lord. Yeah, that is really expensive. It is way more expensive than I would have even thought. Why is my money going down all of a sudden? Their rating is not affecting me that much. Why is my money going down all of a sudden? That doesn't even make bloody sense. Oh well, whatever. So you're the other fighter guy, so speed of horse, I guess, because that's really all that you're doing. I mean, you're commanding horses, cavalry. You're commanding cavalry, so, I mean, what else can I really do with you? Not really much of anything. Yeah, so you have to get into the water back there, unfortunately. Do I go on the offensive against these guys? Because I really am going to need to deal with all this before they get very far. I don't know. Whatever. Oops. Alright, so anyway, I need to go. So I will see you in the next episode. Let's go ahead and set you guys to go after these dudes over here. Because we need to contend with them as quickly as we can. Really? You just scattered all over the damn place, aren't you? And you're kind of stupid, so whatever. Whatevs. Yeah, I don't know that we can really do a whole lot with don't know that we can really do a whole lot with any of these other factions, really. None of them are terribly happy with us. Yeah, I don't think we can really do a whole lot with any of them. We can try to be friends with the dwarves.
All here are honored dwarfkin.
Uh-oh. Does that put me at war with the vampire counts? No. Good. Just realized that they're at war with them, and we just went into a military alliance with them, so I was like, that could be a problem, but looks like we're good. Oh, for some reason, you are not at war with the forces of chaos themselves. It's kind of strange. Whatever. I'll send you on an offensive task to go deal with them. Alright, so we need to continue to reinforce our incomes. Although I don't think at the moment I really have sufficient money to do anything with that. I still need to end the episode that I keep saying that I'm going to do, and I keep not doing it. So, I will do it now. Take it easy. Have a good day, folks. And I guess thanks for watching, so bye bye.